Today's Glassbreaker.
So, Africa today, the Finnfuls stand on the way to up becoming a frontier. Achieved numerous honors, including National Productive Order of Merit, of the Order of the Niger. Reading a book about her life and her up. It's called On Merit. Her name is Georgina Ehuria, Arisa. Thank you so much for bringing the glass ceiling.
Thank you, Sandra.
It's good to have you on the show. First of all, tell me what led you to this.
Sandra, for your program, first of all, and thanks. Let me say from the outset, I never planned to have a career in civil service.
Ah.
As far as careers go,
okay.
That was not my interest. And the civil service, because at that time, I pray to God that we'll be able to recruit it in this country. In the first year in the university, we used to have organizations come to the university to do talent and recruitment. So I had the interview for the Federal Civil Service Commission, and I passed. That was in the East. I attended the time that way. On the way from to attend the interview for my state then the Imo, and then that so and two months after youth service, I got a letter of employment, and I started work immediately in Lagos. That was how I started the job. My uncle then, the later VIP Alauku, was a very famous administrative officer. He was doing very well then, the Federal Civil Service. And he thought I had a very good chance of rising in the service. That was a good result from the university. And he thought I had a very good service. But it was a shock. as soon as I settled down on the job, I actually was applying.
After 36 years, you rose the small migrants meet tube secretary. What factors do you do there?
When I joined the Federal Civil Service, I had just first degree, BA honors degree. Quickly turned on me that first degree was not going to take me far. So those that were at the first, then I used to check their or the non-honorable. Used to write, mine was just be honest. But I saw that the permanent secretary, the directors then, many of them were PhDs, they had master's degrees, they had traveled, you know, attended a lot of courses, these very competent men and women. So that first degree was not going to crack any. So I had to and master's degree. When I finished master's degree graduation, at least it gave me very good understanding of the sector I was working. Gave me ground. I came to the public sector policies. But then, so I had to back a degree in law. Once after I did law, I came qualified, was called to the bar that I was not ready to tell the challenge to climb the woman to the path of Mary. You can get it by being onto that first degree, and then that will take you far. The route that I found, the situation where I could call myself a professional, and I wasn't going to be answering it was forever. So, and I'm very glad now that I'm retired when people ask me, I can say I'm a lawyer. You can imagine if I hadn't. But at that time, I would have been answering retired civil servant by now, which is very depressing.
If you're sure you're listening to her facts, on Nigeria, this part of the glass scene, we take a look at when who anchoring their world, Glaprica, is a civil service, the seven which she climbed all the way becoming the Arisa MON. And one of the things I was very curious about coming to this interview, what were some of the challenges that you faced, first of all, then as a woman, or challenges that were for women, for men? How come them? Because there are lots of men who sit to this seminar. I try to wait for who have come.
When you get to this level, it's very easy to behave as if, you know, you have always been this nice and you've always dressed in these fine clothes. Things have always been good. No. Actually, by the time you see a woman who has risen to the level that I am, you see somebody who has really fought battles and won. And is in a position to talk to the upcoming women and share some very good lessons along the way. Let me start with the problems that women in the world of war. We all may suffer stereotypes, but most of those stereotypes now are really falling away. Some of them are structural, some are cultural. Thankfully, they are being accepted in the world of work up to the highest levels. And we just saw Kamala Harris become vice president in the world's largest democracy. We see women now take positions very civil, and now what it means is that you are the one holding yourself down. All those obstacles they place in the way of our mothers, they have all fallen down. So all the work you bring to us. Mm-hmm. Now, is what I'm called, what you meet in the world, the challenge in a woman. Mm-hmm. First of all, mentorship is very scarce.
Mm-hmm.
Women, they do not like fellow women. So the few who are on top, the people think that they don't like women around them.
Mm.
Because of that, the mentoring that the younger coming women would have got from them, they do not get. And the most position are filled by men.
Mm.
Now, if you go too close to a man, they will start accusing having liaison.
Mm.
So most women, recently we were besieged with this story of something that happened at FCMB, which everybody's waiting for the results of this.
Mm-hmm.
And these are the things that can help you want to grow.
Mm-hmm.
In place of work, women that go to the goal for mentoring.
Mm-hmm.
And instead of being professionals, I learn the ropes of the great,
mm-hmm.
Begin to ask them. Because of that, women miss out on valuable memory.
Mm-hmm.
And when they are supposed to up management, well prepared, mm-hmm. the men arrive top management or the trash top management mm-hmm. better than the women.
Mm-hmm.
So these are the main, and then the third one that's mm-hmm. First of all, women have the opportunity to meet society's expectations by being mothers.
Mm-hmm.
And then,
mm-hmm.
so they which men are not mm-hmm. so they have all the time focused on their career, do the MBA, their MSc, mm-hmm. PhD. You come to the offices, most of the age is the men.
Mm.
So when they place them with women in comfortable hands, mm. and they would have been met on their way to the top
mm-hmm.
by working with
other
mm-hmm. You see, women that mm-hmm. they look.
Mm-hmm.
However, and women do school rush at critical stages in their career.
Mm.
Some of them do not pay attention to work and they become trans. I'm not taking
mm.
maybe tomorrow they will come to work and say, husband is ill. My mother is ill.
Mm.
And my mother is the woman that has to stay at home
mm.
so that the man can go to work.
Mm.
So these are no problems.
Mm-hmm.
Talk about the problems will actually be trans.
How did you get around?
Now, in terms of mentoring,
mm-hmm.
you have to go to the mentor.
Mm-hmm.
And when you go to the mentoring professional, relationship, it's professional.
Mm-hmm.
And when you keep professional, the man will respect that. When you're competent and capable, the man will coach you. But if you are not a serious person, you go and start to the man. You whatever you pay for it. So I always tell women, based on experience, you are capable because the man in work with you in your relationships at attorney.
Mm.
And the second one is, how do you manage this responsibility? By having a network of people that can help you to take care of in the home. And you should never carry those excuses to the office as possible. Just become an issue. People, women, and they allow you to go, but you don't know their
that.
But we have parents and the contact matters we have to handle. This woman cannot be relied,
but
she will always bring up responsibilities. And you don't, last time we see issues, the ones that come up as women, maybe you have a relationship problem. Well, that is so that you need to build up your spirituality, you need to close your God. You need to have a group that you belong for, friends, a group in the church, somebody that is close that you can talk to, so that you do not so much. You don't have a confidence. You're scared of telling people what is body and end up maybe one day we hear this person has killed the husband or the husband killed this person. So I tell women to always belong to a group, whether church, ask the hospital. Sometimes I know human being comfort could have fallback. And some of them have some very resilience is the build that resilience and inside you so that you can stand some crisis that will go at you and away. And always have hope, knowing that if you lost something today, you can double it tomorrow. And I also encourage women about really building capacity. I can never eat enough.
You talked quite on. Tell me why that body addict to find.
That book, yeah, it's my story. It's a very read along and a very, very powerful autobiography.
Hmm.
So I have to say that mine very well. We put a lot of effort.
Mm-hmm.
It's my story, and it is the story of resilience, a story of somebody that refused to give up.
Mm-hmm.
First, I was born in the East, I mean, the Civil War. Then I go through that Civil War, lost years. But when I started school, I was thrown back years.
Mm-hmm.
As young as I went, working hard.
Mm-hmm.
And instead of 6 years, I did primary school in 4 years, and I entered the secondary school.
Mm-hmm.
The same place took me 5 years in the university. So I working, I also met a lot of things. Financial troubles, yes. How did I get through that? By, my girlfriend who was in the banking sector taught me the virtue of being a side hustle, depending solely on your salary, that will bring the crisis on you.
Mm.
As lower and mid career levels. That's when people really experience financial crisis. Mm. Talk me about having dreams of home. Mm. I really am into it. I did a lot of things on the side, including coaching, training. I did a business scene. I did all sorts of stuff. I know. And that took me to that financial depression. Mm. So these are the things you can. I not only spoken, I take you to attain the peak. Mm. When you get to that, mm. secretary is only a few of us. Mm. So I actually looked out at the back. That if you go the way of me, people think it's connectually. Mm-hmm. You need to know. I don't have such a background.
Okay.
And how did I get it? On merit, I start for exams. And I show I always start for exams from grade level until the end. It was by doing well in those exams. When those only one person was selected, mm-hmm. I got the highest mark. I was like, how did I do? I also discussed it in my book. And I show people that there is a window of merit.
Mm-hmm.
And then you can squeeze into that merit. If you don't have the connection of the power of money buy something from the economy that knows everybody.
Mm-hmm.
And you can go back to merit.
Mm-hmm.
But for you to get gold back to merit, you have to be an overperformer.
Mm-hmm.
You need to outperform your peers.
Mm-hmm.
You need to outperform them in your work, in your professionalism. And then you also need to have your moral compass turned north. Because if you don't have integrity, and your moral rectitude is questionable.
Mm-hmm.
It will be difficult for the people who do these selections to really trust you in such a high position.
I had more time to talk some more about this, but we're completely out of time. Where can people pick up a copy of On Meat? Is it available in market stores? Where can copy?
It's launched, but we have the launch of the procedure. I started releasing to some select bookstores, and we does it. And then in Abuja here, we are making arrangements for the book available to the general public.
Okay, all right. As soon as the books become available, I will let you know, of course. Now, before I let you go, we've got about 40. What advice you have young women to work on to have a career who are just starting out in their careers?
They are my favorite people. Just the time is so short, I will advise them. This is the right time to read it.
Mm.
You talk to somebody who is already exiting.
Mm.
It is so that you know the preparations for you to attain the peak of your career.
Mm.
You need to be focused.
Mm.
You need to find out what you want to accept at the job they set in now.
Mm.
If you need a master's, you need a qualification, you need to really do something about a particular skill.
Mm.
This is the time. You need to sacrifice clothes, shoes, handbag, and focus and be disciplined to attain it. Because that is the future.
Girls, thank you so much for being a part of the second break. Carry on with Hard Facts.
Breakfast today, every day, Milo.
Nigeria Info. Hear more than just subscribe to our YouTube channel at Nigeria Info FM. Check us out on Facebook at Nigeria Info 99.3. Follow us on Twitter at Nigeria Info FM and on Instagram at Nigeria Info FM Lagos for live updates as it happens. 99.3 Nigeria Info. Let's talk.